best work he's ever done. How are you doing? Good to see you. Come through, I'll switch off this. What a day. Right, MFR, come down with me. Here we go. I'm at the sort of 90% of the way there, making my spicy cannelloni. So come through the kitchen. Excuse me, miss. So I've been busy, and I've put together the mix, and what I've basically done is chopped some fine onion, really chopped it right down, chucked it in with in a pan with some oil and butter, and then let the onion go and translucent. Then what I've done after that is I've chucked in the mince, some finely chopped garlic, let the mince sort of brown off a little bit, and once that's browned off, chucked in a couple of chilies and a couple of bell peppers as well. And then let that cool once it's browned through, and then chucked in a couple of eggs. And that'll just bring the mixture together for making the cannellonis. The hardest part of this is getting your pasta sorted out. So while the mince was browning off, I took pasta sheets into some boiling water with some oil as well so the sheets don't stick. And that's how you get your pasta cooked. But the fun part now is putting it all together. So what I've got here, basically a couple of clean dishcloths and my pasta. And then I've got the mixture inside, and it does look a bit dry now because it has had time to cool, but once we put it in the oven, we'll smother it with more of the sauce, and I'll finish it off with some cheese as well. So, this is the fun bit. Steady hands needed. We'll just roll it over like that. And what I've got there is a little drizzle of just chopped tomato sauce, some mozzarella cheese. We bring it over here. You getting this, Steve? It's like Floyd-y. And then we chuck it in there. So there we've got a tray of cannelloni here. So we'll just chuck on, it's just basic tomato sauce, nothing fancy because your flavour's in the mixture. And we'll just douse a bit of that on. Look at that, eh? Just like Mama used to make. And then we'll just get a spoon and just give it a bit of a coat. And that'll just keep everything nice and moist. It doesn't have to go in the oven for long. The oven's been preheated for quite a while. I think that'll do us. And then you just want some grated cheese. Let's have a wee swatch. There we go. Let's chuck it on. Don't be shy. Don't be shy. Cut the cheese. Okay, how's that? Good. Looking good. Now, you want the cheese really just to melt. You don't want it hardening up or really going all sort of like flambé-like on you. What we'll do is we'll get some cracked black. Thing is, when you're chefing and when you're putting pepper on a dish, never do it too close. Always from a great height. I'll do it, a bit of that. Okay, and then oven's been on 220. I think that's gas mark, either 7 or 9. So I've had the oven on, it's well preheated. Just chuck this on. I need to get my oven gloves out. Fancy, eh? Not as fancy as a penny, but fancy enough. Here we go. And I'll just move this down, just so it's in the centre. And that's that one. It's been a busy day. I've still got lunch to make as well, so I'm going to have it now. It's in the sort of, get a bit of hummus, a bit of key floating at me, get myself a wee glass of wine. Are you driving? So, all the best. 20 minutes, that'll be ready. And I've got some spare cannelloni here, so I'll get them sorted out. Just to say about everybody else, Nikki's doing pea and prawn risotto. Quite a difficult dish to do. I know she's using arborio rice, which is really the only rice you should use. You can, with risotto, you can cheat a little bit and use other rice, but arborio rice really does soak up the ingredients really well. And if you've got proper stock and it's constant stirring and cooking and cooking, I've got a funny feel. Nikki being as particular as she is, she'll do well with that, but doesn't say she's going to win. And Oxy, I was doing enchiladas. Enchiladas, I think you've got to get spot on. You know, anyone can do the fajitas and stuff these days with the old El Paso and all that, but enchiladas you've got to get spot on. Excuse me a sec. If I was paying proper homage to Floyd, we should have been outside and stuff. Excellent. Right, so Oxy's doing enchiladas. Aldi's doing something I'm actually quite intrigued to see. He's doing haggis lasagna. And he was saying to me the other day, he wasn't really sure to do. I'll give him a couple of tips with the lasagna. So even if Aldi wins, I've still got part of I've still had part of that achievement of his. But put it this way, if Nicky wins that way, it's going to be a breakfast trophy. But I'm going to win. It's that simple. 20 minutes time, you can have a wee taste yourself of the old cannelloni. Okay, should be almost ready now. Let's go in here. Feel the heat. There we are, look at that. Not bad, not bad. We'll just get a wee portion served up here. Just cut into it here. Just make sure to separate it. It'd be nice to serve it as the tube. So just need to watch what we're doing here because this will be absolutely toasting. I think we've got about three here. Let's chuck it on. A bit of sauce here. There we are. Okay. A little bit of black pepper. Fork. So here we are. My dish for Come Dine With MFR and the Allan Studio. Spicy cannelloni. When's a your domino day?